After the heroes returned Celius back to the Astral Academy, life went on by as quietly as one can expect in the kingdom. The three heroes went about their lives, while back at the Astral Academy, students labored hard to impress their teachers. One student in particular was under scrutiny. Cornelius Cranstead was yet again trying to keep up with the demands of his professor.
Go to the Astral Archives and find a copy of the Esoteric Encyclopedia for the next lesson.
I'd be happy to, Professor Button. If you could have only told us where the library archives are. Probably search every nook and cranny and hope for the best. What's this? A music box? I wonder if it still works.
Please, just 5 more minutes, Margaret.
Wake up, wizard. It's time for action.
Is that a doggy I hear? Don't worry, little pup. Help is on the way.
It was night time in the kingdom, and the heroes of Trine were deep in sleep. Sinister powers had been at work, however, and they ended up sharing a common dream. Seemed a rather familiar little dog wanted once again for the heroes to give chase to. And if Toby was present in the hero's dream, then Celius was sure to be nearby as well. Yeah.
This mutt again.
Can you hear me?
Prince Celius? You're not tampering with dream magics, are you?
I had to reach you somehow. There's been a magical accident at the Astral Academy. We need your help. Follow the dog and you'll find us.
Your nightmares aren't on the loose again, are they, Celius?
Actually, it's a dream curse we're dealing with. But not one cast by me. The other students were in the Great Hall rehearsing a play for the Autumn Review. Something went wrong and everyone was sent into a magical slumber. We're trapped here.
after-school detentions. Rudolphus the Strange disturbing his classmates with cat noises during class. The Mechanical Owl eating parchments in class and claiming it to be a part of homing pigeon training. Oof. Marvek the Torrid set his homework on fire. Again, write a parent letter to his wife. Also, suspend whoever stole my keys.
Celius, are you the only one immune to the curse?
No. I'm with a student who remains unaffected.
Owl salutes heroes. Owl is a machine, so no dreams for Owl. Owl hopes the Trine heroes find the culprit. Maybe it's a dragon. A huge, sleeping, gas-breathing dragon!
Let's hope it's not.
Thank you.
the heroes of Trine care to try and solve this puzzle. Unsurprisingly, my students couldn't figure it out. How would you go about it? Good enough. And next, a surprise quiz.
Sorry about that. My last lesson with Butternut didn't go very well.
A little heads up would have been nice.
Thank you.
An old music box plays a hauntingly beautiful melody.
As if there were not enough disturbances in the class already. I do love coming back to the Astral Academy time and time again. It is, after all, where our grand tale started in the first place.
The small key has traces of flour all over it.
The master of the curse is hiding in one of the student's dreams. My portal will lead you there. You shouldn't be in danger because you three aren't actually here.
I see. We are sleepwalking.
Sleepwalking or not, let's save these little wizards and arrest the cursorer!
Looks like I can't evade the heroics even in dreams.